When we finished VI High number 14, we had pulled out some random names from our name array, but we noted that we often ran into duplicates, and we said that we would be coming back to item 3 in our implementation plan to find and replace those duplicates. There are again a few ways to do this, but remember the primary characteristic of our implementation should be robustness. Robustness. Let's first be aware of some of the characteristics of the duplicates. Sometimes we only get one duplicate, or in poker terminology, a pair. Look at Sarah. Sometimes we get two pair, like two Aruns and two Veronicas. And sometimes we'll get three of a kind or more, like greedy Mindy here. And so we need to search through this array of indices to find these duplicates. First, let's clean up this block diagram. Then, let's use a for loop, which will auto-index. With this array of indices. And we want to compare this element to every other element in the array, which means we'll bring in the entire array and disable indexing. And now we'll want to remove this element we're checking from this array. And we'll use the delete from array function to do so. The iteration terminal will supply the appropriate index. So now we'll put another for loop inside of this one and index the array without the element we're checking and compare the element we're checking to every element in here with an equal function. So is this equal to this? If this is true, we'll want to replace the element in this array that we're checking. So within a case structure, we're essentially going to duplicate this little block of code over here, except we're doing it for a single element instead of an array. So I'll hold down Shift and click, 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 and then hold down Control, click, and drag them over here. Now this new element I just created is going to replace the element we're checking, the index of which is here in this iteration terminal of the outer for loop. And so we'll use a replace array subset. I'll hold down Control, click and drag to give us some more space. Delete this auto wiring that wasn't helpful. Wire this array into here, disabling indexing. That's the index and the new value. And note that the array that I used the replace array subset with was the full array, not the one from which I had removed that element in question. I'll wire the resulting array to the order. Disable indexing on both of these for loops, their output. And in the false case of the case structure, we'll just wire this array through because we didn't find a match and we're not changing anything. Now we want these for loops to keep running until they've run through all elements in the array or they've found a match. This is a perfect use case of a conditional for loop, which is available in LabVIEW 8.5.1 and beyond. So I'll right click on the border of the for loop, conditional terminal. Once again, I'll hold down Control, click and drag to create some space. And now I'll wire this Boolean to the conditional terminal. And we'll do the same for the outer for loop. and disable indexing, we just want one value. So what do we do now? Have we entirely fixed the duplicate problem? Well, no, this implementation will fix a single pair if we're again invoking our poker terminology, but what about the two pair, or the three of a kind? Remember Greedy Mindy. This implementation won't address those problems, so we need to take the entire array after the replacement and run it through the same process again. How do we do that? We'll wrap these nested for loops in a while loop. Give some space, and we'll use a shift register to send this array back to the beginning and run it through the same process again. So the input array will no longer come through this tunnel, but rather the shift register. And what condition will stop the while loop? We'll know that we don't need to run the while loop anymore when both of these for loops stop running and they didn't find a match, meaning that this wire will be false. So we'll change the conditional terminal on the while loop to continue if true, wire that value to it, disable indexing, and so the while loop will stop when the Boolean value is false. Now the output from here will be a set of 6 unique indices, so we'll just drag this little block of code, control, click, and drag, over here, and make another output, real winners, excitedly. And run it. We see that we're successful by checking that in the case where there's a duplicate in the winners list, like Santiago, it is replaced with a unique name in the real winners list. Run it a few more times. We have 2 Shu Lees and only 1 in the winners list. Fantastic. Well, that's it. This VI is ready for action, which it will see after 11:59 p.m. Central Standard Time on June 9th, when the sweepstakes ends. If you haven't entered yet, get to it by visiting the instructions at news.sixclear.com. And once again, good luck.